It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday. Let's pretend we're actually working today and we didn't film this before Christmas. It's the Wizard Product Review.
And on this week's show...
Right, first up on this week's show, it's finished now, is Banded by Garrett Thomas.
By Garrett...
Thomas.
Thomas.
The man behind the...
And also... a million other things.
Yeah, fantastic. Yeah. He of the we've still got the DVD sets in stock as well, but this is a different effect, banded. It's basically like your finger ring.
Mm-hmm.
It is your finger ring, but you can have it handed out for examination.
Yeah.
You place it on your finger, and then you proceed to melt it through onto the next finger, and so on onto the next finger, then finally onto your little finger, and the spectator can take it off your
and
finger.
And examine it, and then you can carry on doing some other phases with it.
It's lovely.
It's fantastic. It really is. Well, first of all, I should point out that it's by Cosmo Magic.
Right, okay.
And Cosmo did a fantastic job of the production value.
Great DVD.
You've got a performance to real people in the street.
Yeah.
Then you've got a studio performance.
Yeah, so on the live performance, you couldn't see the effect as well.
But it was
as
nice to see the spectators'
really like,
reactions.
Because you like to see the effect dead on. You want to look at it straight on, really. So he does it straight to camera.
Then there's an explanation to camera, then an explanation over the shoulder.
Yeah, it's not the sort of thing that you're going to pick up straight away. But it's one of those things. It reminds me of when I got Three Fly for the first time, the Bob Cola Three Fly. You get it in your hands. And you want to start playing with
it.
Yeah,
you start practicing
and
it's
you get
fun.
Addicted to it, and it's a fun thing to practice. And if you like the effect and you think it's worth working on, like I do,
mm-hmm.
I think you're going to be rewarded with a very strong piece of magic at the end of it.
Yeah, I haven't got it to a level yet where I can actually perform it and take it out, you know, and actually do it to real people. But I have a feeling that when I am at that level and I am ready to work it, I think that it's going to get some very strong reactions.
I enjoy performing it, and you're messing around with it, and I've already come up with a couple of little moves that I've changed my own moves.
That was
really
good.
If that works out, that'll be quite interesting.
And
I really like it.
It'll be a good lead-in, I think, as a great lead-in to a ring and string routine, because you can do that with your finger ring, and then you can say, well, hang on, that's what I... Let me borrow your ring.
And then go into the whole presentation.
Exactly.
I like it.
Garrett's a great teacher.
He's fantastic. If you're going to put the work in, and I think you'd need to put a little bit of work in, the gimmicks are first class that you get with it.
Perfect,
you need to make
yeah.
sure that you get the right size and take note of the advice that's given on the website about the size you need to order.
He's also got that bonus thing. There's a bit of bonus material.
Extra
where
tips
talks,
on the ring thing
and that sort
of thing. It's good. It's a very simple effect, but it looks fantastic. I'm going to give this 89%.
You know what? I'm going to give it 91%, and I think we should give it Worker of the Week.
Do you reckon? I think it is Worker of the Week. I'd like to work on it a little bit more. It's not an instant effect, but I think it could... Go on, yeah.
I know everything else that's on the show, and trust me, that is... I can't think of anything else that's going to be Worker of the Week.
It's the best effect on this week's show.
Definitely.
If it's your sort of thing, it's our sort of thing, Worker of the Week.
Worker of the Week, 91%. Well done, Mr. Garrett Thomas. My hat's off to you.
Right, here we go. Get ready to be blown away. Put an M&M or a Skittle in your hand and it just disappear. It's a miracle. Just a miracle. Look, I've seen the video.
You've
trailer. I've watched the trailer. This can't be done, mate. It just goes like that and the Skittle is gone.
Yeah.
You can do it any time you're eating Skittles or M&Ms. It's great. You just like, oh, God, I'll show you something with these Skittles.
You know what?
And you put it there and it just dissolves. And
Oh, I've got no opinion on this. This is what
yes,
I
you have.
Okay, I have got an opinion and I'm gonna
go.
This is what I hate. I haven't done a good rant for a while. This is what I hate about magic. People bring out
magic
this
for
stuff.
YouTube.
People bring this stuff out. Enchantment bring this out. They put the trailer out there saying, hey, this is the best thing ever.
With
you
a cool DVD cover.
And it's just blooming awful. It really is bloody awful. It's not very good at all. Who are they putting
this
out for?
It's better than SOS coin production, which was a similar thing to this. In fact, it's almost identical, apart from instead of arm hair, you get gimmicks in with this that make it a bit more practical than SOS coin production.
What's wrong with taking a real flipping Skittle, putting it in your hand, doing a false transfer, coughing and eating the bloody thing, and then having your hands completely clean? It's a Skittle, you can eat it. I don't know, but
I can't do that. That's far too technical. I'd rather rather use the little gimmicks.
Why do you need to be gimmicked up all over your hands? Have little plastic things, have little bags and boxes.
But there's nothing exciting about it. You can't buy your like monthly magic trick and it come and say, do a French drop.
Exactly.
You need a little velvet bag with bits in. That's what keeps you going, the little velvet bags in life.
If you watch the trailer...
with little bits of stuff that you go...
If you like
and 44 minutes in, you go...
You're talking over me.
I'm never going to win this debate, am I?
If you like the trailer, then learn a false transfer, get a bag of Skittles and do it that way. Because the whole reason for this effect, in my opinion, is to fool magicians. If you want to go down the magic...
It fooled me.
Yeah, if you want to go down the magic club and fool your magic buddies, as long as you make them stand right there...
Sit them down on the bar stool and say, don't move your head too much. Like
don't
that.
Move, yeah, then that's fine. If you're going and working the real world or you're working for real people, forget about it. 5%, no good.
6.
Happy New Year!
It's not you. Right, keep filming. We've tried doing this 5 times now.
I'm beginning to feel like that big card trick that you did. Remember
the
3
it's a bit of
prints?
A nightmare. Look, Happy New Year. It's the last show of the year. We just wanted to say we've got loads of products coming out at Blackpool. We're working on them now. And we've got a big announcement, haven't we? It involves everybody in the UK.
It's huge.
It's going to be a major project. We can't tell you too much about it. We don't want to wind you up either. But there'll be a big announcement in Blackpool. And it's tied in with something that we'll be doing in Magic Live in Las Vegas.
Las Vegas, baby.
At the
We're
end of the year.
We're going to Las Vegas. I'm excited.
I just can't cope with it.
It's Las Vegas.
Let's have another review. Right, next up, we've got a review of a very, very big, thick, chunky book.
Stop the presses. Remember this moment, because there's a very good chance you'll never see it again. A book came into review at WizardFX headquarters, and Dave didn't immediately go, oh, it's a book. Here you go, Craig. Go off and learn it. No, instead, he's actually took it home and learned it himself. And the reason is, it's about subjects I know nothing about. I haven't got a clue. I haven't got a first clue about illusions. And this is a book all
you
about illusions.
You have to handle it like an illusionist, you see.
And for those of you that don't know, David Penn, very successful illusionist. Didn't you win the Illusionist of
I
the
Year?
I
get regular gigs at the WI. I'm doing all right.
Haven't you just bought a new illusion or something?
I have bought a new illusion, but don't say anything about that. That's
anything.
For secret stuff later on in the year.
Okay.
It's going to be good in 2011. And part of the thing with illusionists is you kind of want
to
try and
you
stay ahead
this.
Of the game. Yeah, you have to do that. You should take it up. You'd be good. You'd be good at this sort of thing. Seriously, think about FISM. It's only a year and a half away. Let me tell you a bit, first of all. Mark Parker, I've known Mark Parker now for about 10 years, and he actually designed one of the illusions that I performed when I won the British Grand Prix Championships at Blackpool with the illusions, an illusion called the Reducer, which looked like a very small version of an ultimate zigzag where a girl goes in, a tube goes through, and a hand comes out. And I remember the reaction from the magicians on the night because I produced a second girl from this box and it was totally unexpected and it was a very unique illusion.
Right.
And when you're entering a competition, you need something like that.
Right.
You need people like Mark Parker to say, I've got something new for you. And unfortunately, I think over the past sort of 20 years or so, illusions haven't moved forward as quickly as they should do. Obviously, there's a lot of pioneers out there, but Mark has written some very inspirational books, and this one is very inspirational. There's a lot of new ideas in there. There's a foreword by Brett Daniels.
Okay.
Brett Daniels is one of my favourite illusionists. His take on illusions is brilliant. He's got a great performance style, and his Marilyn Monroe illusion is one of my favourites. Foreword by Brett Daniels, that really gets you into the book. There's essays in there. Basic essays on sort of hiding places and that sort of thing. And then, of course, there's illusions. And these are conceptual. You don't get full building plans in here. I think if you would need to have something built, and when you read this book, you're very tempted, you're going to need to go to a good illusion builder. Peter Hart in the UK, Bill Smith in Vegas, or Willie Kennedy in Las Vegas.
So, let me ask you a question. So you pay £100 for the book.
Yeah, which is nothing compared to the price of an illusion if you're looking to do something special.
Okay, so you pay £100 for the book and basically it's adverts on on illusions that you would then have to go and pay to get built?
You would have to get the illusions paid. You would have to pay to get these illusions built, that's right. But unless you actually read the book and see these concepts and read the concepts through, you're not really going to get any idea. Okay. And it's not the sort of thing that's available in the public domain, so you need to get the book. There's some fantastic ideas in here. Bodybuilder, this is one, which is kind of like, it looks a bit like an interlude, a very sort of skeletal style frame, which is empty, and then you dress it up with panels and then somebody can appear inside it. That means nothing to you, does it?
This last 3.5 minutes.
When I mention interlude, do you know what I'm talking about?
That's that like the break in the middle of a show?
No, that's the thing where the people crawl through your body. 95% gone. One of my favourite illusions is Jim Steinmeier's Audience Dismember. The success with that illusion...
Oh, hang on, I think I know that. No. Oh, yeah.
The success in that illusion is getting a spectator up from the audience. I do. And you can do this with a member of the audience, but you vanish them. Apart from their heads and their feet, the rest of the body vanish. Great thing is you can do that on a member of the audience.
Really?
That's another thing that makes that very, very good. There's loads of illusions in here, different designs for tables, that sort of thing. There's some really top-notch illusions in the back. Vivisection. I believe Bill Smith has already started building this one. This is the center of somebody's body actually vanishes, and you can turn their body around. And the methodology, the illusion technique that's going on here is quite revolutionary. And then something at the back that I've got my eye on, which is the motorbike production.
Oh, you told me about this. You said you wanted to produce a motorbike.
Yeah, I might have to speak to Mark about that. But the book is inspirational. It's not cheap. It's not for everybody. But if you're interested in illusions...
I can't rate that. What's the rating?
You're going to love it. I'll give it 95%.
But it's not Work of the Week.
It's not Work of the Week, no, because it's very limited. Who's going to read it?
But 95%.
It's excellent. I love it. You're not getting it.
I don't want it.
We forgot to mention on last week's show that we have got...
Earlier this afternoon.
The one that we filmed 20 minutes ago. We have got loads of roughing fluid in stock. If you haven't got your own supply of roughing fluid or a roughing stick...
And come on, if you've watched WizardFX.tv, you know you're going to need some roughing fluid.
Hopefully, you're going to want to do that lottery trick. Right, last review, Craig...
Ambitious Classic by
It's a classic. Of course it is. You put the card in the middle of the deck and it rises to the top.
No, Dave,
I don't need
Dave,
a DVD
Dave,
on that.
Dave, that's not Ambitious Classic.
Everyone
makes
Everyone
that mistake.
No. Everyone knows Ambitious Card.
No, that's not Ambitious Card. Ambitious Classic was a plot by Larry Jennings.
Right.
And it's a completely different thing to Ambitious Card. A lot of people use it as a follow-up to Ambitious Card, but it's not Ambitious Card.
Right.
You know, I'm going to show it
How
you.
Come it's a classic and I've never heard of it?
Well... It is. It's a classic. Honestly, it's a classic. Shall I tell you? Look, I'll tell you what. You know what? I opened it up half an hour ago. I can do it already.
Really?
I really can.
You can do it already?
I can do it already.
Can we get John off the sticks?
John,
can we have a look at it
now?
Let's
get it off the sticks. So this is better than like Extreme Burn, Ultra Sinise.
Well, I'm not sure about that.
No. You know that David Stone trick?
Yeah.
That's David Stone DVD.
Inspirational, mate.
This is more inspirational than that.
Okay.
This is brilliant. So we've got a deck of cards, right?
Yeah.
And you've got to imagine...
Is it gaffed?
No, regular deck.
Right, okay.
I want you to imagine that I've just done a 47-phase Ambitious Card routine.
Yeah.
Which is part of my working set.
I know.
Yeah. and I'm just about finished, and I've done my big finale. It's come to the card. It's
pipe
to
and
the
slippers
top.
Time, is it?
Well, yeah, because what happens now is I take out 5 cards,
yep.
And I do exactly the same trick, but with less cards.
Right, okay.
Okay.
Isn't there a rule in magic, don't repeat the same trick?
Yeah, but it doesn't...
Does it bores your audience?
It doesn't follow with this.
Right,
trust
okay.
Me, here we
this
go.
Is a classic.
So you got 5 cards.
Yeah.
Yeah? You've got a 5, you've got a 4, you've got a 3.
That's great. Did you write this
you've
back
got a
to yourself?
Two. Now, Michael Amar did.
All right, okay. he's a champion, though. He can get away with it.
I can get away with this, trust me. Oh, by the way, Dave, can you turn those cards face down?
Yeah, why is that?
Might help with the method.
All right,
mess them
okay.
up a bit more.
Right.
That's quite cool. Brilliant. Right, here we go. 5 cards.
Yep.
There you go. Now, if I turn them over... Very good. That's worked. I'm going to start off with the ace.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the first one. Now, I want you to watch. It goes down in the middle. And I want you to see there's no dodgy moves. It really is going into the middle.
It's really in the middle,
It really
yeah.
is in the middle, isn't it? Now, watch this. You put it all the way in the middle. You push the button on top. And when you do, that ace comes straight to the top, just like Ambitious Card.
Well, it's the same trick.
No, there's less cards. And that's the ace. That's the first card. You see, ace is one. That's
so you do,
do it
instead of a deck.
No, because this is where it gets clever, right?
Right.
Because then you put the ace away, and you just do it with 4 cards. So now you do right. the two, because that's the next one, you see. You're just
doing this, like, again, with less... Right.
So we're going to do it again now with the two.
Yeah.
So you put the two in the middle.
It's not getting more exciting, though, is it, Craig?
Well, it is, because then you push it, and now it's gone through less cards, so it's building, you see.
Right.
But you can do each phase more than once, so I'm going to do the two again.
Jesus, is he man or beast?
I'm going to do it again, watch this.
Right.
Where's the two?
Two down.
It's in the middle.
Yeah, three down.
Say the middle.
The middle.
Thank you. You push it all the way in.
Push the button.
You push it. Oh, see, that's where it
believe
builds.
It.
And look at that. It's back on top.
Oh.
Guess what? Too many cards.
Too many cards, yeah.
I'm going to do it now with the three. Here we go. I'm going to do the three. I'm going to take the three.
Yeah.
And this time, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it right there in between the four and the five. Because if you think about it now, you've only got a top, a middle, and a bottom. You don't have anything else. You have a top, middle, and a bottom. So if I put the three in between the four and the five, I can't make it come to the top, but if I shake, it actually turns face down in between the four and the five. Now, it turns face down in between the four and the five, and you might have missed that, but if I then put it face down back in between the four and the five and shake, now it actually turns face up. See, there it is, in between the four and the five. Of course, we're using too many cards, so I'll tell you what, we'll just use the four and we'll just use the five. Yeah, we'll just use the four and we'll just use the five. There's the five, there is the four. Now I want you to see, there's the front of the four, there's the back of the four, there's the back of the five, there's the front of the five. Okay, I'm going to do it really, really slowly. I want you to watch, there's the five. I'm going to put the five to the top, the four is on the bottom. Now I want you to see, there's the five on the top. All I have to do is push, and just like that, now the four's on top. It's come all the way up through the cards. Now the problem is, there's too many cards. I'm going to get rid of the four. We're just going to use the five. Now if you think about it, there's no top, there's no middle, there's no bottom, there's just one card. So if I could make it come to the top now, it wouldn't be very impressive, unless I press the button one last time, and you see, the joke's on you, the joke's on me, because the five has been on the top the whole time. Absolutely brilliant. It's a real classic, don't you? Dave!
Sorry, mate, have you finished?
Weren't you watching the...
So, I just went out to get a coffee. Sorry.
But you missed the trip.
Yeah, I know, I was getting bored.
But it's a classic.
We'll see you next week on the Wizard Product Review. You can follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and all the usual places.
I didn't even give a chance to rate it.
I'll leave that up to the viewers.